squats, with the presses, with everything that encompasses the CrossFit shit. YouTube, what is up? I just arrived at Strong Fitness or CrossFit Strong in Dallas. I'm about to take this Saturday, Sunday to do the CrossFit Level 1 training course and possibly start coaching at the box that I have been going to and working out at for the last year and a half. So it's pretty exciting. I'm pretty pumped up, but I just want to bring you guys along, tell you guys my thoughts after the day's concluded and then tomorrow with the test. Just, you know, maybe some pointers for you guys, what you might want to bring with you, this, that, and the other. I brought my backpack full of goodies, which I'll explain what I have here in a little bit. I'm gonna go ahead and get inside though. It's about 8:23 a.m. in the morning. They say to arrive at 8:30 for the registration, and then things kick off about 9 o'clock. So stay tuned. Man, I gotta tell you what, this is pretty sick. Just got to the lunch break. I think there's like 60 people in the class that I'm taking, about 4 coaches, and they're all like level 3, if I'm not mistaken, like certified CrossFit coaches, and they train across the states. It sounds like a lot of them travel and go to different boxes, different CrossFit gyms, and teach this level 1 training course, if not maybe even level 2 or 3. I don't necessarily know all about those just yet. I'm taking my level 1, right? So the beginner's course, the rookie course. And holy smokes, I found some things that were, I didn't find them, the coach found something, Kevin, that was wrong with my overhead squats. I need to like tighten my core up. Just little things that you don't realize almost for the last year, year and a half, that you're almost kind of doing wrong. You need to perfect this technique, and now I can translate this to others that I maybe coach in the future at the gym. And so it's gonna be pretty cool if I pass this test tomorrow. But I'm on the lunch break. I'm actually over here at In-N-Out. Probably not the best thing to get, but I'm gonna have a cheeseburger, screw it, and I'm gonna get back there. We're gonna do a workout at some point, and then I got a split tomorrow. I'm gonna probably stay a little later and just pick the coach's brain and talk about affiliating and just opening up a box or asking them questions about it at least. And I'm just excited, man. It's better than I thought it was gonna be. The focus is a whole lot on just longevity and overall health, fitness, and dieting, nutrition. It's pretty crazy. You're just getting a glimpse of everything because this is only the level 1. But you know, just like going over the movement standards and being able to correct people when they're making faults with the movement, you're basically learning how to coach folks on the processes, and it's a ton of fun. So I recommend it to anybody who hasn't thought about participating in this level 1 course, whether you want to coach or not, just for yourself as an athlete to improve. Yeah, we'll catch up with you here in a bit. All right, we got to get back after it. Don't take it from me on going to In-N-Out as a good idea during your CrossFit level 1 course. I got my fit aid, got me the full-on number 1, y'all. I wasn't gonna have the fries, but I did, and I skipped the soda and I went with a chocolate shake. So, you know, we should be straight for this CrossFit workout they're gonna have us do. I'm not too worried. I'm not gonna drive live film, so I'm gonna stop filming. Hopefully I can put a sweet little edit together for you guys, but no filming during the lectures, etc. So I'm gonna go ahead and sign off until the next check-in. So I got permission from the owner to kind of show you guys around now that the lectures are over and we're set and done for the day. Whew. We did some movement training on squats, presses, like, you know, the shoulder press, push jerk, air squat, overhead squat, all this good stuff. We're just chilling after class. We actually did an entire workout. I'm gonna show you guys the workout up on the board, but I'm gonna take you around the place. Tell me that's not dope. Place is huge. So Eddie's gonna show us around. He's a beast. He actually, you go here, right?
Yes, I go here.
Oh, man.
This is our Olympic weightlifting room right here.
Check this out. Say what? There's more. True forms. Never even used these. This is sick. Okay, so the heart rate room, we'll call it.
The heart rate room.
What else we got? Let me show you all the main complex then, because this is where the magic happened. We had all the bars out. This place was full, man. I think it was 60 of us.
Yeah.
About 60 of us in the class. And the workout we all had to do was 3 rounds for time of 15 thrusters and 12 burpees. And I got lucky, I actually got the fastest time of 3 minutes 45 seconds. My partner, it was so sick, my partner Gus, he killed it. He actually got 3 minutes 48 seconds, and then the majority of the group was in like the 4 minutes, 5 minutes type of thing. So let me show you what we had up on the board, take you guys around the rest of this place. CrossFit Strong in Dallas. First day CrossFit Level 1 training. We're gonna resume this tomorrow. I'll see y'all then. Peace. What up, guys? Second day lunch break, and we are having a blast. Today we focused on med ball cleans. We did a lot of progressions, starting with the deadlift, sumo deadlift high pull to follow, then the med ball clean. We also talked about and are going to talk about the GHD and muscle up following the lunch break here. We did a workout this morning, which was, it was a lot of fun. It was actually a lot of our first times kind of coaching a high intensity workout, and so what it was today was the med ball cleans and sit-ups. And so there was only a couple standards that we're looking for on the sit-up, but then of course the med ball clean, there's a lot of things that you want to focus on, the hip extension, the just dropping right below the ball. Instead of doing like a power clean, you know, you just get the deadlift, shrug, and then drop. You want to drop down below it and then end with the full, you know, you stand up at the end of the rep. So it's the first time you're put out of your comfort zone in an environment where you're having to make corrections on the fly, and you know, you want to focus on, like, let's say that med ball clean. There's things that I'm looking for that I haven't had to look for before, like hip extension. And so I'm telling my partner, I'm like, okay, you know, like, touch my back, lean back a little bit, get the hip extension. And then all of a sudden his knees are not fully extended, he didn't get entire full extent. It's just little things that are so crazy, you you don't understand unless you're put in that coaching environment, I guess. So it was I learned a lot today, and I'm kind of excited for the second half. Then there's the test that we all got to take to get our certificate. And you know, some things that you probably want to bring with you is, in my backpack I have all my workout gear. I didn't like bring my lifters or nothing, but I have, you know, like wrist wraps, I've got my knee sleeves, I had my belt, weight belt, different things like that. And so, you know, you're kind of prepared for whatever the workout might be. I'm sure it constantly varies, but for us yesterday it was thrusters and burpees. So I wanted to make sure that my wrist was feeling good throughout the whole thing. So I wore the wrist wraps, for instance. Some people had their knee sleeves, etc. Those are some things you might want to bring with you, is going to be the workout gear. Make sure you bring in your snacks, because, you know, you're in class all day long. You're not going to want to get up out and about except for the lunch break. So bring some fluids with you. Make sure you got plenty of water. And then also just understand that you're here to learn. So go ahead and bring your notepad, pen and pencil. You're gonna be here over these 2 days. You might as well make the most of it. You paid $1,000 for it. That's the cost at the time of this video. So man, soak it all in. This has been a blast, and I can't wait to start utilizing the training I've learned in the future. So we'll go ahead and hop back in there, and I'll just catch you guys in a little bit. Wrapped up. We are back at the house, and just showered, and man, I'm ready to just kick back and relax and enjoy the rest of the Sunday evening, because it has been a long weekend. I'm gonna go ahead and drop some more details and information in another clip here in about a week or so, because I'm gonna get my results emailed to me. So when that comes in, I'm gonna hit you guys again with a bit of an outro and just some kind of final thoughts and everything about the whole process. But so stay tuned.
We got the results.
Marshmallow, how'd I do?
Zeke, tell him. Justin, what did I get?
King, how'd I do?
Gina, did I pass?
You got it?
You got it?
Woohoo! Alright! Congratulations, your certificate will arrive within 4 to 6 weeks from today's date. Alright, so I wanted to leave you guys with a few extra things as well. I'm gonna drop this information down in the description, but make sure, if you guys are interested in this course, for one, you look up which ones are in your area and which ones you can actually be a part of, because they fill up pretty quickly. So what you're gonna wanna do is just go to crossfit.com, and then you're gonna click the top, if you're on your mobile device, you're gonna click the little drop down and go to courses, level one course, and then you can check out all the details, the itinerary, the cost, and then you go to the very bottom and it should say register. And what you're able to do then is view all the upcoming courses throughout the states, etc. And so you'll be able to see which ones are full. They're indicated by like a red bar on the right side, which ones are almost full, yellow, and which ones have quite a bit of space left, which is gonna be shown in green.
And so I took mine at CrossFit Strong in Dallas, such a fun experience. And this is how you're gonna get set up for that. But also I wanna tell you guys to go through the level one training guide, CrossFit level one training guide. You can also find that on CrossFit.com. If it's a separate link that's easy to get to, I'll just send that one straight to you in the description as well. And I actually just put it on iBooks. And so I had my CrossFit level one training guide at my fingertips at all times. And I was reading it, you know, like 10, 20 pages at night before bed, leading up to the course. And I recommend maybe reading through it twice. It's a lot of pages. On here, it's 258. I think even if you get the paper bound one, it's 240, it's 200 plus. And so you can get that, you know, printed out. They have the PDF, or you can actually order it. If I'm not mistaken, I believe it's around $40. I just went with iBooks because you can open it in PDF and then save it to iBooks and it's free. So that's what I ended up doing. But one thing's for sure, this level one training guide is just gonna pretty much encompass everything that the test is gonna be over. So you're gonna wanna read through this a time or two, three, five, 10. It doesn't matter if you're a good test taker and you can remember all this stuff the first time, the first read, then good for you. But I thought the test was a little sketchy. I was kind of worried, like, did I make it? Did I pass? Did I not? And so I just recommend reading through this multiple times, whether you're gonna be there taking notes at the lectures or not. So it's definitely a training tool for you that you need to utilize. And then also, guys, what else do I wanna say? And lastly, I'm pretty sure the workout is the same across the board whenever you take this course. And the one that's really fun and exciting because you're really pushing yourself is the thruster burpee workout, where it's 3 rounds for time of 15 thrusters, 12 burpees. So whether you take the course or not and you want to try this workout, but specifically if you do take the course, it'd be really cool in that environment with all those people around you cheering you on and you feel like you're really pushing, you're being real competitive, let me know if you beat my time. I know there's some top tier athletes that, if I'm not mistaken, are probably completing it in the 2 minutes, because really it came down to me, the thrusters. You know, like the thrusters is where I had to take my break. The first 15, unbroken, quick as anybody else, and then the burpees flying through them. First round, piece of cake, right? And then second round, I broke it up 8 and 7. And it was pretty tough to pump out those 7 right there for that second set to complete the 15. Dropped back down to the burpees. I went as fast as I could, and then I went back over the bar and we did 15 more thrusters, and it was just 5, 5, and 5. But I actually got the fastest time still, just because of the fact that I think my burpees were very quick and I just minimized the rest every time I would drop the bar. So for instance, my partner Gus, he got 3 minutes, 48 seconds. And if I'm not mistaken, he did the thrusters unbroken. He might've split up the last set actually, but his burpees were at more of a controlled pace. Anyways, if you beat 3 minutes and 45 seconds, or if you do this workout in general, and I just want you guys to post your times down below in the comments section. Let me know how long it takes you to finish this workout. It's gonna be pretty cool seeing what times you guys are getting from across the world. Hopefully you guys also let me know where you're chiming in from, where you're viewing this video from, and where you took it at. It'd be cool to see if you guys are taking this course in other countries and how it relates to this, and if your experience was very similar, the same, entirely different. So I'll catch you guys on the next video. I don't always do CrossFit vlogs. This is my first one actually on the channel. A lot of it's fishing. So if you guys are interested in subscribing to some fishing videos, go ahead and hit the subscribe button somewhere over here, and then check out maybe some of my other videos I've got for you guys I think you might really like. I may start doing some more CrossFit vlogging here in the future, so stay tuned.